women movement, regional movement, and religious and communal movement. So as we discussed in the last class by Santosh Mathur itself about the Dalit movement, the backward class movement, and other social movement, and how the social movement are so much relevant in the global, in the era of globalization. So today we'll be focusing on this particular four movement, and let's have a clear idea on that particular movement. And like I would request Santosh Mathur to deliver his lecture, and I would also request all the learners, please don't leave now, don't leave the session now, and we'll take your questions after the session. You can ask as many as question you can ask, or any clarity or any doubts. So now I would request Dr. Santosh Mathur to deliver his lecture. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Antariyami, for giving me this opportunity again. And today I've been assigned again four topics: ethnic movement, women movement, regional movement. So let me begin with the ethnic movement, with a special reference to tribal in India. So here I would like to define first what are the ethnic movement. Actually, I have divided my first topic, which is ethnic movement, in the two, three parts. First, in the first part, I would like to define what is ethnic movement actually. And then the second part, ethnic movement, there are various approaches. So I will deal with three approaches actually, which is the part of your syllabus. And the number three, ethnic movement during the post-independence period, after independence of India, and the ethnic movement with special reference to India, in which I will try to define what are tribals actually, what is the definition of tribal in India, which we call Adivasi, and how Constitution of India defined the tribals in India, and what is the difference between tribals of Northeast and the rest of the country. So let me begin the first part, what is ethnic movement actually. So first you need to understand what is ethnicity actually. So ethnicity is a notion, we can say that ethnicity is a notion or idea that refers to a social entities where we share common features like common religion, common language, common tradition, common religion, etc. So in a simple terms, ethnicity is a cultural phenomena. It's a cultural phenomena. It is, don't get confused ethnicity with race, because some people use ethnicity interchangeably with race. So race and ethnicity both are different. Ethnicity is a cultural phenomena, and race is a biology cult term actually. Race is like, for example, Afro-American people, which we call black, they are actually, which is the category of race. So ethnicity is completely different from the race. So don't get confused. So we can say that ethnicity is associated with the identity of certain social group, a certain group of people, on the basis of common language, religion, tradition, customs, history, culture, and economic experience. So those group of people or social group share common identities. What is common identity? Common identity is your culture, is your tradition, is your language, is your religion. It's called ethnicity or ethnic. Theek hai, ethnic movement. But in India, in Indian context, like if the mobilization is based on caste, which we call what? The caste mobilization or Dalit mobilization. If the mobilization is based on language, which we call linguistic mobilization. Hana? Linguistic mobilization. If the religion mobilization is based on the religion, then we call it a communal mobilization. But when we are talking about this ethnicity, so any attribute or any characteristics, जो भी हमने अभी बात की है, वेदर इट इज द आइडेंटिटी, कल्चर, ट्रेडिशन, लैंग्वेज, उसको हम एथनिसिटी ही बोलते हैं, बिकॉज दी स्कॉलर्स और दिस पॉलिटिकल साइंटिस्ट फॉलो द अमेरिकन यूरोपियन ट्रेडिशन. सो इन द अमेरिकन यूरोपियन ट्रेडिशन एनी एट्रीब्यूट और एनी करेक्टरिस्टिक्स वेदर इट इज अ लैंग्वेज रिलीजन कास्ट एट्सेट्रा इज एथनिक मोबिलाइजेशन और एथनिक मोबिलाइजेशन. तो इसको हम दी बिकॉज वी फॉलो द यूरोपियन एंड अमेरिकन ट्रेडिशन तो हम इसको एथनिक मोबिलाइजेशन ही बोलेंगे. वी कॉन्ट कॉल इट दी दलित मोबिलाइजेशन और लिंग्विस्टिक मोबिलाइजेशन. ठीक है, बिकॉज वी फॉलो दिस अमेरिकन एंड यूरोपियन मॉडल. सो दी स्कॉलर और पोलिटिकल साइंटिस्ट लाइक पॉल आर ब्रास यूजेज एथनिसिटी एंड कम्युनल मोबिलाइजेशन इंटरचेंजेबली. एक की जगह दूसरा वो यूज करते हैं. बट दी पोलिटिकल साइंटिस्ट और सोशल इंडियन सोशोलॉजिस्ट दीपांकर गुप्ता वो इसमें डिफ्रेंशिएट करते हैं. ठीक है, ही डू नॉट यूज इंटरचेंजेबली ethnic mobilization or communal mobilization. So according to Dipankar Gupta, ethnic mobilization is related to nation state, territory and sovereignty. ठीक है, so ethnic mobilization is related to nation state, is related to territory of state, is related to the state actually. While the communal mobilization is not related to state, is communal mobilization according to Dipankar Gupta is related to रिलेटेड टू टू कम्युनिटीज और द गवर्नमेंट. जहाँ पे एक कम्युनिटी ब्लेम कर रही है गवर्नमेंट को फॉर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन कि हिंदुओं को जो बोल रहा है वो मुसलमानों को नहीं मिल रहा है. ठीक है, तो दीपांकर गुप्ता इसको अलग अलग यूज करते हैं. बट दी पॉल आर ब्रास जो कि एक यूरोपियन पोलिटिकल साइंटिस्ट हैं वो इसको इंटरचेंजेबली करते हैं. ही डज नॉट मेक एनी डिफ्रेंशिएशन बिटवीन द एथनिक मोबिलाइजेशन एंड कम्युनल मोबिलाइजेशन. ओके, सो ये एक आप डिफरेंस है. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ एथनिक मूवमेंट इन इंडिया इज व्हाट द एथनिक मूवमेंट इन इंडिया इज कंसर्न विद द प्रिजर्वेशन एंड प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ द कल्चरल आइडेंटिटीज ऑफ द सर्टेन ग्रुप्स और सर्टेन एथनिक ग्रुप्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेट्स से द ट्राइबल्स ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्ट द नागा ट्राइब्स वो राइट फ्रॉम द बिगनिंग कभी भी इंडियन स्टेट को और इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को रिकॉग्नाइज नहीं कर रहे थे. वो मानते थे कि नागा जो है इट इज अ सेपरेट एंटिटीज, दे हैव अ सेपरेट रिलीजन ट्रेडिशन कल्चर, वो इंडिया के साथ कहीं भी मैच नहीं करता है. सो दे वर टॉकिंग अबाउट राइट फ्रॉम द बिगनिंग द नागा स्टेट. तो वो इसीलिए उनका क्या है कि दे हैव अ डिफरेंट आइडेंटिटी, दे हैव अ डिफरेंट कल्चर, दे हैव अ डिफरेंट ट्रेडिशन, दे वॉन्ट टू प्रिजर्व दैट कल्चर और ट्रेडिशन. So any ethnic movement is always concerned with the preservation or protection of certain identities of these ethnic groups. Okay, so this is all about the ethnic movement in India. So now I'm moving on the approaches to the study of ethnic movement. In your syllabus, there are three approaches mentioned in your syllabus. One is a primordial approach. Primordial means ancient. पुराना जिसको हम बोलते हैं, ओल्ड जिसको बोलते हैं, अर्लियस्ट जिसको बोलते हैं. सो प्राइमोर्डियल अप्रोच वॉज फर्स्ट प्रपोज बाय एडवर्ड फिल यूरोपियन साइंटिस्ट. ही क्लेम दैट द पीपल ऑफन हैड अ प्राइमोर्डियल अटैचमेंट टू द टेरिटरी इन विच दे लिव. जिस जगह से हम आ रहे हैं उसके साथ हमारा वी हैव अ स्पेशल कनेक्शन और स्पेशल अटैचमेंट. इफ आई कमिंग योर लाइक यू ऑल आर कमिंग फ्रॉम संबलपुर तो आपका एक स्पेशल अटैचमेंट होता है संबलपुर से. ठीक है, सो प्राइमोर्डियल अप्रोच इज टॉक अबाउट द अटैचमेंट टू द टेरिटरी इन विच दे लिव और फ्रॉम विच द पीपल आर ऑरिजिनेटेड. सो लाइक द फैमिली इन विच यू आर कमिंग, द कास्ट फ्रॉम इन विच यू आर कमिंग. सो कोई भी जगह, रीजन, कास्ट, फैमिली या आपका जो भी किन है वहाँ से आप आ रहे हो, उसके लिए जो आपके अंदर स्पेशल अटैचमेंट होता है उसके बारे में ये जो थ्योरी है वो बात करता है. सो दिस अटैचमेंट इन्वॉल्व स्ट्रॉन्ग फीलिंग ऑफ लॉयलिटी कि आई एम कमिंग फ्रॉम सर्टेन ABCDZ ट्राइब और कास्ट और रेस तो मुझे क्या है उसको प्रिजर्व करना है. उसको हम बोलते हैं एथनिसिटी. सो इट इज कनेक्टेड विद अ स्ट्रॉन्ग फीलिंग और सॉलिडरिटी हम बोल सकते हैं. So they are bound to be conflict with different ethnic groups. तो क्या है, क्योंकि मेरी हम इसमें क्या करते हैं कि माई एथनिसिटी इज सुपेरियर देन योर एथनिसिटी. तो जब ये सुपेरियरिटी वाला कॉम्प्लेक्स आता है तो यहाँ पे क्या होता है कि हम कॉन्फ्लिक्ट हो जाता है वहाँ पे. सो इसीलिए इंडिया में हम देख रहे हैं कि दे आर लॉट्स ऑफ एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट मूवमेंट, जिसको हम लेटर पार्ट में डिस्कस करेंगे. इन द सेकेंड अप्रोच इज इंस्ट्रूमेंटल अप्रोच. इंस्ट्रूमेंटल अप्रोच, वॉट इज दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंटल अप्रोच? इंस्ट्रूमेंटल अप्रोच बिलीव दैट एथनिसिटी इज इमेजिन, इज क्रिएटेड. हु क्रिएटेड एथनिसिटी इज नॉट अ नेचुरल, इट इज क्रिएटेड. क्रिएटेड बाई द इलीट, क्रिएटेड बाई द पोलिटिकल लीडर्स फॉर देयर ओन बेनिफिट. सो फर्स्ट क्या बोलती है कि एक अटैचमेंट के बारे में. फर्स्ट थ्योरी, द डिफरेंस बिटवीन फर्स्ट थ्योरी एंड सेकेंड थ्योरी, फर्स्ट थ्योरी इज अ प्राइमोडियल थ्योरी, वो एक अटैचमेंट के बारे में बात करते हैं, लॉयलिटी के बारे में बात करते हैं. इंस्ट्रूमेंटल थ्योरी क्या बोलती है कि जो एथनिसिटी है इट इज ए क्रिएटेड. क्रिएटेड बाई हुम? क्रिएटेड बाई द पोलिटिकल लीडर्स और द इलीट. हु आर दिस पोलिटिकल लीडर और इलीट? दे आर कमिंग फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर ट्राइब और पर्टिकुलर एथनिसिटी. उन्होंने अपने पोलिटिकल मोटिव्स को बेनिफिट करने के लिए दे हैव क्रिएटेड दिस एथनिसिटी, ठीक है. एंड दे हैव जनरेटेड द कॉन्शियसनेस अमंग द दैट पर्टिकुलर ग्रुप ऑफ एथनिक पीपल. So ethnicity is created, imagined or constructed. ये लोग ये बोलते हैं. But there is another theory, which is a combination of these two theory, primordial and the instrumental theory. Okay, वो bipolarity में believe करती है. It believe that the basis of ethnicity either is given or created. Given कौन बोल रहा है? The primordial theory. Given की कुछ characteristics हैं उसमें, ठीक है. और क्रिएटेड इज द सेकेंड थ्योरी, दैट इज द इंस्ट्रूमेंटल थ्योरी. बट ये थ्योरी इनको क्रिटिसाइज करती है. देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम विद दिस अप्रोच. व्हाइल प्राइमोर्डियल अप्रोच डज नॉट एक्सप्लेन व्हाई एंड हाउ, प्राइमोर्डियल अप्रोच डज नॉट एक्सप्लेन व्हाई एंड हाउ द एथनिक मोबिलाइजेशन इन टू कलेक्टिव एक्शन. कि ये एक्सप्लेन नहीं करती है कि एथनिक मोबिलाइजेशन जो है हमारा वो कैसे हो रहा है, उसको एक्सप्लेन नहीं करती है. बस ये करती है कि मोबिलाइजेशन हो रहा है, बट इट डज नॉट एक्सप्लेन कि ये मोबिलाइजेशन एक कलेक्टिव एक्शन में कैसे रिजल्ट दे रहा है, ये एक्सप्लेन नहीं करती है. व्हाइल इंस्ट्रूमेंटलिस्ट अप्रोच डज नॉट एक्सप्लेन एज टू व्हाई एन एथनिक ग्रुप रेस्पोंड टू द कॉल ऑफ इलीट लीडर्स. दैट मीन्स कि जो इलीट लीडर्स हैं, जब वो कॉल कर रहे हैं मोबिलाइजेशन के लिए, तो उनके कॉल पे क्यों रिएक्ट करते हैं, इनको जरूरत ही नहीं है. तो इंस्ट्रूमेंटल थ्योरी डज नॉट एक्सप्लेन दिस कि व्हाई ऑन द रिक्वेस्ट ऑफ लीडर्स, ऑन द रिक्वेस्ट ऑफ इलीट एथनिक पीपल, ये क्यों रिकॉग्नाइज करते हैं. तो उस चीज़ों के बारे में ये थ्योरी दोनों साइलेंट है. सो दीज वर द थ्री थ्योरी अबाउट द एथनिसिटी. So now I'm coming, moving to next, that is the ethnic movement during the post-independent period, since independent, we can say that, since independent. We all know that India is a very unique country. There are lots of tribals, thousands of castes, and more than 1,000 languages people spoke in a different region, different state, different union territories. There are different tribes, they have a different sect, different religions. So India is a very diverse nation, actually, which has a very diverse culture, tradition, customs, religion, etc. So, and India have witnessed many ethnic movements since independence in the forms of the movement of regional autonomy. Regional autonomy means jahan pe ek region hai jo autonomy ki baat kar raha hai. Jaise apne within Uttar Pradesh there's a demand of Harit Pradesh, Bundelkhand, hai na? Like in Assam, there's a demand of Bodoland. Bodo is a tribe. They are demanding for separate entity or a separate state for the Bodo tribe. So in the there's a expression of ethnic movement in a different forms, like regional movement of regional autonomy for creation of separate state, demand for succession, or insurgency, etc. So sometimes this is called, some scholar called the movement of self-determination. ये क्या है जो ethnic movement है? It is a movement of self-determination. कि जहाँ पे लोग अपने आत्मनिर्णय के अधिकार की मांग कर रहे हैं, वेदर इट इज अ ट्राइब और सर्टेन अदर कैटेगरी ऑफ पीपल और रीजन, ठीक है। तो और समटाइम क्या हुआ है, इन सम केसेस एथनिक मूवमेंट गिव राइज टू द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट और राइट, देखा होगा आसाम में कि जो एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट हुआ देन लेटर स्टेट इट वॉज कन्वर्टेड इन टू द राइट, दंगों में बदल गया है, ठीक है। बहुत सारे एग्जाम्पल आपको इंडियन हिस्ट्री में मिलेंगे इन द लाइन ऑफ एथनिक डिवाइड, जहाँ पे व्हाट इज दिस एथनिक डिवाइड, जहाँ पे एक एथनिसिटी क्लेम कर रही है दैट वी आर सुपेरियर इन टर्म्स ऑफ एथनिसिटी देन द अदर ट्राइब या जो भी आप बोल सकते हो। सो द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रिजेक्शन ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बाय नागा इज गुड एग्जाम्पल, ठीक है, जो राइट शुरू में ही मैंने बोला। सेकेंड इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ लिंग्विस्टिक स्टेट, 1950 में ही पहला स्टेट बन गया था हमारा आंध्र प्रदेश, वाज द फर्स्ट स्टेट विच वाज फॉर्म ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ लिंग्विस्टिक, जब आफ्टर द डेथ ऑफ पोटू सीतारामल्लु, ही वाज अ गांधीयन हु डाइड आफ्टर 54 डेज हंगर स्ट्राइक बिकॉज ही वाज डिमांडिंग फॉर सेपरेट स्टेट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ लिंग्विस्टिक लाइन। सो ये भी रिजेक्शन ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बाय नागास, नंबर वन एग्जाम्पल, नंबर टू फॉर्मेशन ऑफ लिंग्विस्टिक स्टेट्स, नंबर थ्री तमिल एथनिक मूवमेंट अगेंस्ट द इम्पोजिशन ऑफ नॉर्थ इंडियन हिंदी लैंग्वेज, वहाँ पे 1916 में देयर वाज अ ह्यूज मूवमेंट इन तमिलनाडु अगेंस्ट द एंड हिंदी स्पीकिंग पीपल, और उसका रीजन ये था कि इंडियन गवर्नमेंट वॉज ट्राइंग टू इम्पोज हिंदी ऑन तमिल्स, सो तमिल रिएक्टेड कि हमारा लैंग्वेज तमिल है हम क्यों हिंदी बोलें, ठीक है। सो इसके खिलाफ भी मूवमेंट हुए हैं एंड द एथनिक मूवमेंट इन पंजाब वॉज बेस्ड ऑन थ्री इशूज, नंबर वन रीजनल, रिलीजियस एंड इकोनॉमिक, ठीक है, दिस वॉज लेड बाई द अकाली दल। अकाली दल इज अ फेमस रीजनल पार्टी ऑफ पंजाब, आप नाम सुना ही होगा अकाली दल, एंड अकाली दल आर्ग्यूड दैट सिख फॉलो द सेपरेट रिलीजन, सेपरेट लैंग्वेज, दे स्पीक पंजाबी एंड देयर रिलीजन इज सिखिज्म, सिख जिसको हम बोलते हैं, बोले कि हमारा वी हैव अ डिफरेंट रिलीजन, डिफरेंट ट्रेडिशन, डिफरेंट लैंग्वेज, देयरफॉर वी डिजर्व फॉर सेपरेट स्टेट। सेपरेट स्टेट किस पे बेस्ड होगा, ऑन द एथनिक लाइन, व्हाट वुड बी द एथनिक लाइन ऑफ द सेपरेट स्टेट वुड बी द सिखिज्म, सिखिज्म जो सिखों का रिलीजन है, एंड दिस मूवमेंट इज लेड बाय पंजाब सूबा मूवमेंट विच स्टार्ट इज इन 1950 and then in the separate Punjab was created as a separate state in 1st November 1966 and the second state was created Haryana for Hindi speaking people. So pehle before 1966 it was the one state jahan pe Hindi speaking and Punjabi speaking people were living. So there was a conflict between Punjabi speaking and Hindi speaking. So separate state was created. So it was also on ethnic divide or ethnic line aap bol sakte ho. Then again in 1980s Punjab saw another movement which was where they were demanding the Khalistan, separate state Khalistan. So this the demand of Khalistan also challenged the Indian Union or Indian state, theek hai, on the ethnic divide, जिसमें ऑपरेशन ब्लू स्टार, उसके बाद में मिसेस गांधी की हत्या भी, सी वाज असैसिनेटेड इन 1984। सो ये कुछ एग्जांपल हैं। देन एथनिक मूवमेंट विद सो दीज ऑल द मूवमेंट विच वी डिस्कस्ड कैन कीप इन द पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस एरा। सो नाउ आई एम कमिंग टू एथनिक मूवमेंट विद स्पेशल रेफरेंस टू ट्राइबल्स, ओके। सो in fact I can say that the tribals provide the most appropriate example of ethnic movement in India. So agar kisi bhi identity ko aap ethnic movement mein rakhna hai to tribal movement are the best example which we can keep in the category of ethnic movement. So the most common issue which account for the tribal ethnic mobilization are, number one, the real threat to their indigenous color, indigenous culture. Ethnic movement India mein kya ho rahe hai? Because tribals, they are facing threat to their indigenous culture. All the tribals, they have a different language, tradition, culture, all these things. So unke liye kya hai? Threat hai. इसलिए वो दे आर गेटिंग यूनाइटेड एंड दे आर मोबिलाइज दे आर गेटिंग मोबिलाइज अगेंस्ट दैट थ्रेट थ्रेट फ्रॉम द एक्सटर्नल्स ट्राइबल्स एंड नॉन ट्राइबल्स वाला कॉन्सेप्ट हम रख सकते हैं इसमें सो नंबर वन रीजन इज अ रियल थ्रेट टू देयर कल्चर नंबर टू इंक्रोचमेंट ऑफ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज बाय द आउटसाइडर्स बिकॉज ट्राइबल्स आर एसोसिएटेड विद जंगल दैट इज व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड आदिवासीज सो देयर लाइवलीहुड एवरीथिंग डिपेंड ऑन जंगल सो वेन एवर देयर इज अ इंक्रोचमेंट ऑन जंगल बाय द आउटसाइडर हु आर दीज आउटसाइडर outsider they may be the bureaucrats non tribals businessmen or leaders jab bhi inki taraf se encroachment hota hai to the jungle so they react and they get mobilized against these outsiders so number 2 reason ye hai ki encroachment whenever there is any encroachment from the outsiders they get mobilized ki isko hame khatam karna hai second reason is a discriminatory policy by the सेंटर और सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ये भी बहुत बड़ा इनके लिए थ्रेट है सो दीज आर द फ्यू रीजन देर लॉट्स ऑफ रीजन बट आई एम लिस्टिंग दीज थ्री रीजन एक्चुअली बिकॉज ऑफ दैट एथनिक मूवमेंट आर हैपनिंग इन द कंट्री सो लेट मी डिफाइन हु आर द ट्राइबल्स दे आर आदिवासी पीपल अकॉर्डिंग टू आर्टिकल 342 ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन 342 ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन which defines adivasis article 342 how this article defines adivasis or tribals on the basis of three element or three point one is a isolation that means those the group of people those who are living in isolation alag kahin par reh rahe number 1 number 2 backwardness number 1 is a isolation number 2 is a backwardness number 3 is a unique culture so any social group who is living in a isolation and backwardness and cultural uniqueness are called scheduled tribes so this is the definition this is given in the Indian constitution under article 342 so tribals are associated with jungles forest their livelihood depends on forest shifting cultivation was very famous among the tribals abhi usko band kar diya hai government ne because wo usme jungle kata jata hai bade level pe so this has been stopped now so if you see the population of tribals in India as per the census of 2011 is they comprises approximate 8.6% of total population of India are tribals so major the entire northeast region is the majority of tribals different tribals and the tribals of northeast are called frontier tribals and the tribals of rest of country are called non frontier tribals because un log front pe rehte hain so maybe this is the region that is why they are called frontier tribals okay so tribals let me come on to just tribals of northeast India northeast region ठीक है सेवन स्टेट एंड सेवन सिस्टर वन ब्रदर्स उनको बोला जाता है आसाम ठीक है ऑल दैट सो यहाँ पे सो दिस नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया हैज लार्जेस्ट नंबर ऑफ ट्राइबल पॉपुलेशन एंड दीज ट्राइबल्स फॉलो डिफरेंट रिलीजन्स मेजोरिटी ऑफ दीज ट्राइबल्स आर क्रिश्चियन दे ऑल्सो फॉलो बुद्धिज्म हिंदुइज्म एंड देयर इंडिजीनियस रिलीजन एंड Further, the tribals of Northeastern are divided on the basis of tribals of plain and hill. Those who are living in a hill region and the plain. So that is also another category of tribals, plain tribals and the hilly tribal. So ethnic movement. So here I would specifically talk about the ethnic movement in Nagaland, Assam and the Meghalaya. See a specific movement in this section so let me come straightforward on ethnic movement in Nagaland okay so Nagas are they are living in Nagaland basically so Naga movement is often referred to a Naga insurgency are called they also call it Naga national movement Naga National Movement, Naga Insurgency, and Naga Movement, all are same. Okay, so Naga believe that they form a nation. Naga itself form a nation, which is different from the other ethnic groups of the Northeast region. And they had always enjoyed the sovereignty. So Naga are different. They are different from the other tribals, other ethnic group of Northeastern. That is why they form the separate state and they have a sovereignty and all that. So with unique culture, custom and history, they never been a part of India. They believe that they never been a part of India because they have a different culture, tradition, religion, all that. So they were never been a part of the India. They do not recognize the Indian constitution as well, because they believe that we are not part of this country. So therefore they do not recognize Indian Union or Indian constitution. Unka manna hai ki hum alag hain ekdam in terms of culture, tradition, everything. Mein hum kya hai? We are separate from the rest of the country, whether it is a UP, Odisha, hum alag hain. So therefore they Naga club was formed in 1918. It was pre-independence era to take up the social and administrative problems of Nagas. So Nagas form Naga club in 1918. 1918 mein Naga club banate hain. In the 1927, Naga delegation, Naga sent a separate delegation to meet Simon Commission. Simon Commission, which came into India in 1927 to provide a framework on social and political administration for India. So they Naga met the Simon Commission and they requested Simon Commission not to include Nagaland in the forthcoming administrative political reforms. Then in 1940 mein, Naga formed Naga Council. 1940 Naga Council was created. Later it was renamed Naga National Council. Naga National Council. 1980 Naga Club, 1945 Naga Council. Then it was made Naga National Council. So Naga National Council agreed to sign an agreement with India, Governor of Assam, in June 1947. The main provision of this agreement was the main provision of agreement include the protection of Naga tribal land, ki hum kya karenge, Naga tribal land ko protect karenge, and creation of administrative autonomy for Nagas. So there was two major provision of this agreement. Number one was the protection of Naga tribal land. Number two, the creation of administrative autonomy for the Nagas. These were the two major provision of this agreement. Then in 1947, Naga announced the formation of the People's Sovereign Republic of Nagaland. It was a kind of separate country. The formation of People's Sovereign Republic Nagaland and Hong King government was formed in the Nagaland to look after the Naga affairs. So this was formed. And when Naga formed the separate state or separate government from the Indian government, and it attracted resulted the conflict between Union of India or Indian government and the Naga government. So this was followed by, this conflict is followed by 16 point agreement between Naga Council and Indian government. So Nehru signed this agreement actually on behalf of Indian government, and finally led the creation of Nagaland. This agreement led the agreement which was signed between the Pandit Nehru on behalf of Indian government and the Naga Council, created the separate Nagaland. So Nagaland was made a separate state within Union Territory on 1st August 1960. So on this issue also, there was lots of differences between Naga leadership. So because of this, Naga leadership was divided into groups. One group formed the Nagaland Nationalist Organization, and another group formed the Nagaland Democratic Party. Nagaland Democratic Party was So they formed two groups. So one group, Nagal National Party, was in favor of separate state, while another group, Nagal Democratic Party, was in favor of the giving of violence and accepting the Indian constitution. So एक यहाँ पे क्या कर रहे थे, नहीं वी आर नॉट रेडी टू गो विद द इंडियन स्टेट, क्या हमें सेपरेट स्टेट चाहिए, वाइल द अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वॉज इन द फेवर ऑफ कि हमें भारत के साथ मिल जाना चाहिए और उसके कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को एक्सेप्ट कर लेना चाहिए. सो यहाँ पे दो ग्रुप. सो फाइनली इन 1975 द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट एंड नागा काउंसिल साइन द शिलोंग अकॉर्ड, Shillong agreement. So Naga accepted, by this signing of this agreement, Naga accepted the Indian constitution and they deposited their arms to the Indian government on the condition that all the Naga political prisoners should be released. So those who were arrested, they should be released and hum taiyar hai Nagaland usko karne ke liye. So this matter was resolved in 1975. Again Naga, nowadays Nagas are demanding the their demand is for greater Nagaland. So they often now they are having ethnic conflict with Naga tribe and the Kuki tribe, which is residing, the majority of Kuki tribe is residing in the Manipur. So abhi they are demanding for greater Nagaland, which should be formed from the Nagaland and the some part of Manipur. Uski ye baat kar rahe hain. ठीक है. सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट दी नागा ट्राइब. नाउ आई एम मूविंग ऑन दी बोडोज ऑफ आसाम. इज अ बोडो ट्राइब विच इज लिविंग इन आसाम. सो इन आसाम दे आर टू फेमस ट्राइब, बोडोज एंड कार्वीज. दे हैव बीन ऑल्सो इन्वॉल्व इन अ कलेक्टिव एथनिक मोबिलाइजेशन सिंस 1980s. सो बोडोज एंड कार्वीज आर डिमांडिंग क्रिएशन ऑफ सेपरेट स्टेट फ्रॉम दी आसाम. सो दे आर नाउ डेज आर लिविंग इन आसाम. सो from e Assam they are demanding for separate state, that is Bodo for Bodo, Bodos for Bodoland and the Karbi Anglong for Karbi tribe. So Bodo tribe are living in the district called Kokrajhar and Karbi tribe is living a district called Karbi district. So they have both the tribes are demanding for separate state. So the tribals of Assam, the tribals of Assam participated in 5-year long Assam agitation led by the ASU, All India All Assam Student Association or Union, All Assam Student Union. So ye movement hua tha 1985 to 89. So all these tribes were very active in this movement. So Bodos are single largest community which is among the notified scheduled tribes in Assam. So their population is approximate 5 to 6% of Assam population. So they first organized the Manipur Bodo state. The demand Manipur separate Bodo state came in 1967 or 68. Then the Assam Accord of 1985 gave rise to Bodo aspiration in 1987. So all Bodo student union revived the Bodo statehood demand in 1985. So first this accord or agreement led the creation of the Bodoland autonomous council with some limited power. So unko separate state na dene ke bajaye kya hua, unko ek limited autonomous status de diya by forming the Bodoland autonomous council. In 2003 second Bodo accord was signed with the Axis group of Bodo Liberation Tiger Force, Bodo Liberation Tiger Force between center and the state, that is the Assam, which led the creation of Bodo territorial council as a part of the sixth schedule, which is related to scheduled tribe. Theek hai. So this is all about Bodoland. So inko bhi kya hai, they were also successful getting the autonomous region within the state, that is the Bodo Territorial Council. Now tribes in Meghalaya. So what is the conflict between Meghalaya tribes? The conflict between Meghalaya tribes is the famous tribes of Meghalaya are Khasi, Jaintia, and Garo. These are the famous tribes of Meghalaya. The unique characteristics of tribals of Meghalaya is they are matrilineal. देयर सिस्टम इज मैट्रिलिनियर, दैट मीन्स यहाँ पे फीमेल का रूल चलता है, पैट्रियार्की नहीं है. इट कम्स इन अ फ्यू ट्राइब्स विच आर मैट्रिलिनियर. सो यहाँ पे क्या हुआ, 1972 ना मेघालय वॉज क्रिएटेड अ सेपरेट स्टेट इन 1972. सो बिफोर 1972 द क्रिएशन ऑफ मेघालय, यहाँ पे पीपल द रेजिडेंट ऑफ मेघालय वर द राजस्थानी, राजस्थानी दैट इज द मारवाड़ीज, बेसिकली बिहारी, राजस्थानी, बिहारी, बंगालीज, ये यहाँ पे दिस वॉज द अनदर पॉपुलेशन. एंड द सेकेंड पॉपुलेशन वॉज द ट्राइबल, दैट वॉज द खासी, जैंतिया एंड गारोज. सो आफ्टर द क्रिएशन ऑफ मेघालय कॉन्फ्लिक्ट स्टार्टेड बिटवीन ट्राइबल्स एंड नॉन ट्राइबल्स. Tribals mean three tribes and non-tribals means the Rajasthani, Bihari and Bengali people. So kya hua, after 1972 when this was created separate state. So the in the Meghalaya Assembly there are 60 seats. So out of 60 seats, 56 were reserved for the tribals and 56 were reserved for the tribals and 4 were kept for the other, these Rajasthani, Bengali and Bihari. And the government jobs were also reserved for these tribes. So this attracted the conflict between tribals versus non-tribals. Okay. So you can say that this is the conflict of resource. Kabhi aap bol sakte ho. सो लैंड रिफॉर्म भी हुआ, वहाँ से लैंड राइट्स भी इनको डिप्राइव कर दिए गए टू द नॉन ट्राइबल्स. सो देन द ट्राइबल्स ऑफ मेघालय दे फॉर्म खासी स्टूडेंट यूनियन KSU विच इज़ वेरी फेमस एंड खासी फेडरेशन फॉर गारो, जैंतिया एंड पीपल, पीपल ऑफ खासी फेडरेशन गारो जैंतिया of people. This is a organization of which is called APKGJP. So it may be conflict hai, but abhi wo ekdam resolve ho gaya with the intervention of the central government. So same with the tribals of the north other region of the India. Okay, so unika, so we can say in conclusion that the ethnic movement is a movement of the tribal movement where they are trying to preserve their identity. Identity means they want to preserve and protection of their culture, tradition, language, etc., etc. So this was all about the this thing, the ethnic movement. Now I'm moving to the next topic, that is the women's movement. So women's movement also falls in the social movements category. So women's in India, also, women also have been involved in a collective action equipped with their agenda, leadership, ideology, and organization in order to have dignified position in the all the field of the life, whether it is a political field, social field, and economic field. So they wanted to have a dignified position in the society. Therefore, they are fighting for their rights, which were deprived to them. Okay, if we see the population of women, there are 50% population of women around the world. I'll give you one example here, that is the example of Indian Parliament. After the 75 years of independence, of Indian independence, I'm talking about, how many percent women parliamentarian are there in Indian Parliament? Only 14%. So it's still, they are, lacking behind. 75 साल के बाद भी their percent is 14% in Indian Parliament. 60 to 70 MP हैं हमारे पार्लियामेंट में, फीमेल एम पी हैं हम आप बोल सकते हैं. सो द नंबर इज वेरी लेस आफ्टर 75 years of independence. So they have been denied the political, economic and cultural right. Does not have right to inherited property. There are many part of country, except few, जहाँ पे they have a inherited right, जहाँ पे पापा की property में उनको हिस्सा मिलता है, otherwise वो भी उनके पास नहीं है. So we can say that the women movement in India is centered around two point जो हमारा एजेंडा रहेगा ऑफ दिस लेक्चर. नंबर वन इज इक्वालिटी, इक्वालिटी इन द ऑल द एस्पेक्ट ऑफ लाइफ, दैट इज पॉलिटिकल, कल्चरल एंड सोशल रियल्म. नंबर टू इज द रोल ऑफ वुमेन इन डेवलपमेंट प्रोसेस, रोल ऑफ वुमेन इन डेवलपमेंट प्रोसेस. सो लेट मी गिव यू दिस हिस्टोरिकल बैकग्राउंड ऑफ वुमेन मूवमेंट इन इंडिया. वुमेन मूवमेंट इन कॉलोनियल कॉन्टेक्स्ट. सो क्या हुआ, इन द 18th एंड 19th सेंचुरी, द 18th एंड 19th सेंचुरीज ब्रॉट द न्यू इकोनॉमिक एंड पॉलिटिकल प्रोसेस इनटू ऑपरेशन इन इंडिया. सो विद द कमिंग ऑफ ब्रिटिशर्स और कॉलोनियल रू कॉलोनियल पावर, दे ऑल्सो ब्रॉट क्रिश्चियन मिशनरीज. And these Christian the role of Christian missionaries was to spread the education or to bring the reform in Indian society. So these Christian missionaries and the British government started criticizing the Indian society and presented big challenge to the Indian political leaders and the intellectuals, because before 19th century social reforms in India, there were lots of social evil were existing, like the sati system was there, child marriage was there, female infanticide was there, and so on. So these missionaries and British government started criticizing the Indian social order or Indian samajik vyavastha hum bolte hain, theek hai. And British colonial rule also introduced new ideas. They introduced modern education, Lord Macaulay. So with the introduction of the new education system, they started reading J.S. Mill, Voltaire, and all that. And all these European writers were talking about the idea of equality, liberty, justice. So ye padhna shuru kara. So because of this, reform movement started in the 19th century. So reform movement started by the Raja Ram Mohan Rai, by establishing the Brahmo Samaj in 1829, Brahmo Samaj. Then the Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar, he made great effort for widow remarriage. He also established a widow remarriage organization. So people like Jyotiba Phule, he started Satya Sodhak Samaj, Dada Bhai Nehruji, and people like IMG Mahadev Govind Ranade, Gokhale, Firoz Shah Mehta, Badruddin Tayyab Ji, they actively campaigning for the women's education and more public space for women. In 1885, when Indian Congress was formed in Bombay, at the same time Indian Social Conference was also formed. So the Congress was looking after the political affairs or political matters, while this Indian Social Conference was looking after the social affairs. So reform in social movement. ठीक है. सो दिस इंडियन सोशल कॉन्फ्रेंस वॉज ऑल्सो इन अ फेवर ऑफ इक्वालिटी फॉर वीमेन, इक्वालिटी फॉर वीमेन. सो दे वर अपोजिंग मैनी आइडियाज, बट द इंडियन सोशल कॉन्फ्रेंस डिड नॉट अपोज द आइडिया ऑफ इक्वालिटी फॉर वीमेन. सो वीमेन इशूज देन द रोल ऑफ गांधी. गांधी वेन गांधी केम इन टू इंडिया इन 1915 and 16 फ्रॉम द साउथ अफ्रीका. So he started taking active part in Indian national movement in 1917 by through this Champaran movement. Then 1920 he started this non-cooperation movement. So he started advocating the greater participation of women in Indian national movement, and he requested the women to come out in the larger number and to take participate in the national movement and the other activities of public life. Before that, the role of women was confined to the four wall of the house or home. So Gandhi requested to the women to come out in the large number and take active part in the politics. In 1927, All India Women Association was also formed, and this All India Women Association was campaigning for the political rights for women. Political right, particularly right to vote and greater participation of women in the formation of government. This was the period. At the same time in Europe, the movement of the suffrage was going on. In the Europe, the women were also demanding the right to vote. सो इसी टाइम इंडिया में भी ये चल रहा था, ठीक है. सो गांधी देन द नेहरू एंड सो बिकॉज ऑफ द गांधी एंड नेहरू एंड अदर पॉलिटिकल लीडर यू सी द आफ्टर 1920 ऑनवर्ड्स द रोल ऑफ विमेन वॉज इंक्रीजिंग इन इंडियन नेशनल मूवमेंट. सो आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस द इंडिया लॉन्च नंबर ऑफ सोशल रिफॉर्म्स रिलेटेड टू वीमेन. सो इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली इन 1948 द रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ कोडिफिकेशन ऑफ हिंदू लॉज वॉज गिवन टू डॉक्टर बी आर अम्बेडकर बाय जवाहरलाल नेहरू की. सो दिस इज नोन एज ए हिंदू कोड बिल. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ हिंदू कोड बिल वॉज द कोडिफिकेशन ऑफ हिंदू लॉज, हिंदू पर्सनल लॉज एक्चुअली. बट हुआ क्या कि बिकॉज ऑफ इन 1951 में इलेक्शन थे, फर्स्ट इलेक्शन 51 एंड 52. सो नेहरू वॉज हैविंग ह्यूज प्रेशर फ्रॉम द हिंदू राइट विंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, सनातन धर्म संस्थान एंड ऑल. सो आइडिया ऑफ हिंदू कोड बिल वॉज ड्रॉप. दिस वॉज लेटर ऑन पास इन 1950, 55 और 56 इन द फॉर्म ऑफ हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट और हिंदू सक्सेशन एक्ट. बट गवर्नमेंट कुड नॉट एंटर इन टू द इशू ऑफ पर्सनल लॉज ऑफ अदर कम्युनिटीज. द क्रूशियल आस्पेक्ट ऑफ देयर लाइफ कंटिन्यू टू बी डिटरमाइंड और गवर्न बाई दी पर्सनल लॉज ऑफ दीज रिलीजियस कम्युनिटीज. बिकॉज फॉर मुस्लिम देर आर मुस्लिम पर्सनल लॉ बोर्ड, फॉर पारसी देर अ पारसी पर्सनल लॉ बोर्ड, सेम विद द अदर रिलीजियस कम्युनिटीज. सो गवर्नमेंट ड्यू टू वोट बैंक पॉलिसी कुड नॉट एंटर इन टू दी पर्सनल लॉ सेक्शन. देन ये एक आस्पेक्ट है. देन द सेकेंड आस्पेक्ट इज रिलेटेड टू वायलेंस अगेंस्ट वीमेन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ब्राइड बर्निंग, विच वॉज द वेरी क्रूशियल इन एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री. वायलेंस अगेंस्ट वीमेन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द ब्राइड बर्निंग, जहाँ पे क्या रहे कि डाउरी मांगा जा रहा है, डाउरी नहीं मिलती है तो ब्राइड को जला दिया जाता था. सो ब्राइड बर्निंग, रेप दैट इंटेंसिफाइड द वीमेन मूवमेंट इन 1970s. 1917, the issues like violence against women at the ground level, rape by the landlords, caste oppression, etc., was made the part of women movement in the 70s or period of 80s after independence. Then in the 80s, there was a very famous case of Shahwano case. Shahwano case was related to the Shahwano was a Muslim woman. It was a case of triple talaq as well. So talaq was given to Shahwano, then she filed a case in the Indore, which is in Madhya Pradesh. Then it came into Supreme Court later. The Supreme Court ordered his husband to give her alimony or maintenance. So this verdict of Supreme Court attracted lots of criticism from the Muslim communities, then Muslim Personal Law Board involved in this. Then the Gandhi was Rajiv Gandhi was formed to overrule the Supreme Court of India, which attracted lots of criticism. Then we have a famous Narmada Bachao Andolan, in which the women play a greater role, an active role. Narmada Bachao Andolan, then the Chipko movement, in which women used to go and वो पेड़ों से चिपक जाती थी, पेड़ों को नहीं काटने देती थी. सो चिपको मूवमेंट, नर्मदा बचाओ मूवमेंट, देन द भंवरी देवी केस. भंवरी देवी वॉज वेरी फेमस केस ऑफ राजस्थान एक्चुअली. सी वॉज अ सोशल एक्टिविस्ट वेन सी वॉज ट्राइंग टू स्टॉप अ चाइल्ड मैरिज. देन सी वॉज सब्सिक्वेंटली रेप बाई द गुजर कम्युनिटी. देन इन 1988 सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया फॉर्म विशाखा गाइडलाइंस which is related to sexual harassment. Then we have a sexual harassment act laws and sexual harassment at workplace, all that. So this was all about the women's movement in India. Now I'm moving to the regional movement. This is the third topic actually. So regional movements in India. India consists of large number of region with a diverse social, cultural composition and different level of development, है ना. इफ वी सी द प्रेजेंट सिनेरियो ऑफ इंडियन पॉलिटी इज वी हैव अ 28 स्टेट एंड 8 यूनियन टेरिटरीज. 28 स्टेट एंड 8 यूनियन टेरिटरीज. सो ऑल these union territories and state have a different culture, different level of development, different level of literacy, and different level of politics. So India is a very diverse culture, tradition, bahut hi diverse hamara nation hai. So even the State Reorganization Act of 1956 did not solve this problem related to regional disparity. Still we have a huge regional disparity. Odisha is different, UP is different, Tamil Nadu is different. All these 28 and 8 union territories are different. So let me define what is regional movement actually. Regional movement is an identity movement. Regional movement is an identity movement seeking special privilege, protection, and concession from the state. State means center. So kya kar rahe hain? In the regional movement is a kind of identity movement for the people, for the region, in which they are asking for separate or special protection, privileges, and the special treatment from the state. So it is also a movement for regional self-governance. It is also an identity movement as well as the movement of regional self-governance. So it encourages people to develop a sense of brotherhood, oneness, which seek to protect the interests of the particular region, promote the welfare and the development of that particular region and people of particular region. Like people are demanding for Harit Pradesh. So the behind the demand of that Harit Pradesh is the objective is to protect, because Western Uttar Pradesh is different from the Purvanchal. So they are also demanding sometime Harit Pradesh or Jatland, both are same from the Western UP. Because in the Western UP, majority of Jat and Gujar. So they are demanding for separate entity for their region. So there are two causes or region for the emergence of regional movement in India. Number one is a inter-regional or inter-community conflict. Inter-regional or inter-community conflict. Number two is a conflict between state and region. So inter-regional, inter-community conflict. Number two, conflict between state and region. So inter-regional or inter-community conflict is the based on insider and outsider complex. Insider and outsider complex. What is this insider and outsider complex? The insider and outsider complex nurtures the nativism and son of soil theory. Nativism and son of soil theory. That means the insider, like insider have a more claim on natural resource than the outsider. So whether it's a distribution of resource, reservation in jobs, and the anti-migrant movement is Assam is one of the example of this, and the tribal and non-tribal conflict over domicile issue in Jharkhand is the another example of this. Okay. Sometime inter-regional conflict is also occurs over the regional pride. Regional pride in the sense, regional pride is rooted in the culture, language, and tradition. Let me give this example of Maharashtra, Shiv Sena. Shiv Sena said that the Maratha Manus, that the Maharashtra is for Marathis. Why it is for Marathis? Because Marathi culture is very rich than the Biharis, than the people from UP. So wahan pe often you see this anti-Hindi speaking movement, jahan pe Bihariyon ko mara ja raha hai, peeta ja raha hai UP ke logon ko. So Shiv Sena, border dispute between Karnataka and Maharashtra. It is also based on the regional pride. And the Kaveri water dispute we can also include in this category. Kaveri water dispute between Karnataka and the Tamil Nadu is also example of this. So the inter-regional conflict is based on insider-outsider complex. Insider means jo us region ke log hain, unhi ka hak hai, unhi ka claim hai on natural resources, on the distribution of resources, on government jobs, baki kisi ka nahi hai. For example, Gorkhaland, in the North Bengal, the region like Darjeeling, Darjeeling, Siliguri, Jalpaiguri, यहाँ पे क्या है, इट इज अ नेपाली डोमिनेटेड एरिया एंड नेपालीज आर डिमांडिंग फॉर गोरखा लैंड. सो उसका भी बेस यही है. एंड द सेकेंड रीजन इज द स्टेट सेंटर स्टेट रीजन कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन स्टेट एंड रीजन. स्टेट एंड रीजन मीन्स दैट मीन्स द रीजन स्टेट कॉन्फ्लिक्ट यूजली टेक्स प्लेस इन अ इंस्टीट्यूशनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्टेट सिस्टम. इंस्टीट्यूशनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्टेट सिस्टम, वॉट इज दिस इंस्टीट्यूशनल स्टेट स्ट्रक्चर सिस्टम इज लाइक वेयर रीजन ब्लेम स्टेट फॉर डिस्क्रिमिनेटली डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ पॉलिसीज. पॉलिसीज इन द सेंस के सेंटर इज एक्सप्लॉइटिंग देयर रिसोर्सेज, नॉट टेकिंग केयर. सेंटर इज बिहेविंग, द बिहेवियर ऑफ सेंटर गवर्नमेंट इज स्टेप मदरली बिहेवियर एंड देयरफॉर दे आर डिमांडिंग फॉर ऑटोनोमी और सेपरेट स्टेट फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर रीजन. सो लेट मी डिफाइन द टाइप्स ऑफ रीजनल मूवमेंट. द टाइप्स ऑफ रीजनल मूवमेंट, नंबर वन बिग इज अ सक्सेशन मूवमेंट. वॉट इज दिस सक्सेशन मूवमेंट इज द फॉर्म ऑफ रीजनल मूवमेंट दैट इन्वॉल्व्स मिलिटेंट एंड फंडामेंटलिस्ट ग्रुप एडवोकेटिंग सेपरेट स्टेट फ्रॉम द इंडिया ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एथनिसिटी और अदर फैक्टर्स लाइक खालिस्तान, डिमांड ऑफ नागालैंड. अभी जो लास्ट टॉपिक में हमने बात करी थी, डिमांड ऑफ खालिस्तान, डिमांड ऑफ नागालैंड. नंबर टू इज अ सेपरेटिज्म मूवमेंट ऑफ सेपरेटिज्म इन विच वी डिमांड फॉर सेपरेट स्टेटहुड विद इन द यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया. सेपरेट स्टेटहुड विद इन द यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया लाइक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ उत्तराखंड, झारखंड, छत्तीसगढ़ इज अ और तेलंगाना इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सेपरेटिज्म मूवमेंट ऑफ सेपरेटिज्म ऑफ सेपरेट स्टेट मूवमेंट. बोडोलैंड, गोरखालैंड, बुंदेलखंड ऑल्सो फॉल्स इन दिस कैटेगरी. नंबर थ्री इज अ डिमांड फॉर फुल स्टेटहुड लाइक द मैनी यूनियन टेरेटरीज आर डिमांडिंग फॉर फुल स्टेटहुड लाइक दिल्ली इज द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ. केजरीवाल हैज बीन डिमांडिंग दैट दिल्ली को कंप्लीट स्टेट का स्टेटस मिलना चाहिए. ठीक है, देन अनदर डिमांड इज अनदर फॉर्म ऑफ द रीजनल मूवमेंट इज अ डिमांड फॉर ऑटोनॉमी बिकॉज इन तमिलनाडु इज डिमांडिंग फॉर ग्रेटर ऑटोनॉमी पर्टिकुलरली DMK द पोलिटिकल पार्टी ऑफ तमिलनाडु. सेम विद अकाली दल फॉर पंजाब, TDP तेलुगु देशम पार्टी फॉर आंध्र प्रदेश. सो दे आर डिमांडिंग फॉर ग्रेटर ऑटोनॉमी. इफ वी सी द करेंट स्टेटस ऑफ इंडिया एज ऑफ लाइक टूडे देर आर मोर देन 30 or 31 डिमांड फॉर द स्टेटहुड एंड सब ऑटोनॉमी अरेंजमेंट आर एग्जिस्टिंग. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल मारू प्रदेश, मारू मीन्स डेजर्ट, मरुस्थल. सो मारू प्रदेश की डिमांड आ रही है फ्रॉम राजस्थान. एंड इन यूपी विद इन यूपी देर आर डिमांड फॉर 3 सेपरेट स्टेट, डिमांड फॉर बुंदेलखंड, डिमांड फॉर हरित प्रदेश, डिमांड फॉर पूर्वांचल. इफ वी सी द मध्य प्रदेश देर आर डिमांड फॉर विंध्य प्रदेश, मालवा, रिवांचल, महाकौशल इन MP. ठीक है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल मिथिलांचल इन बिहार, इवन कौशल राज इन उड़ीसा. पीपल हैव मैनी लाइक पीपल आर डिमांडिंग द कौशल राज. सो इफ वी सी देयर 31 स्टेट ये डिमांड कर रहे हैं. ठीक है, सो इफ वी सी द साइलेंट पैटर्न ऑफ दिस रीजनल मूवमेंट, द साइलेंट पैटर्न ऑफ दिस मूवमेंट आर नंबर वन, दिस हैज गिवन द राइज ऑफ रीजनलिज्म. ठीक है, बिकॉज ऑफ रीजनल मूवमेंट रीजनलिज्म काफी स्ट्रांग हुआ है हिंदुस्तान में. ठीक है, नंबर टू इट ऑल्सो गेव द राइज टू द रीजनल पार्टीज. इफ यू सी द रीजनल पार्टीज आर प्लेइंग द क्रूशियल रोल. ठीक है, नंबर थ्री इट ऑल्सो रीफोकस ऑन द रीजनल इशूज. बिकॉज ऑफ रीजनलिज्म सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट हैज स्टार्टेड फोकसिंग ऑन रीजनल इशूज जिनको पहले वो इग्नोर कर देती थी. ठीक है, सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस in 2001 there was a creation of 3 states, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand and Uttarakhand. Theek hai, and next is the preservation of cultural identities or tradition. बिकॉज जहाँ पे भी रीजनलिज्म की डिमांड आ रही है, देयर ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू प्रिजर्व देयर यूनिक कल्चर एंड आइडेंटिटी. सो इट्स नॉट अ न्यू, द रीजनल मूवमेंट इज नॉट अ न्यू फिनोमेना. इट स्टार्टेड 1948 व्हेन दिस धर कमीशन वॉज फॉर्म टू लुक आफ्टर द स्टेट रीऑर्गेनाइजेशन मैटर्स. सो बिकॉज द डिमांड वॉज कमिंग फ्रॉम the Telangana, when the Potti Sri Ramallu Gandhian, who sat on hunger strike, was demanding separate state in the form of Telangana from Andhra Pradesh on the basis of linguistic basis. So the commission was formed and it submitted its report in 1948 December. It was formed in June, submitted reports in December 1948, which rejected the demand of the linguistic demand was rejected. Then JVP commission, Jawaharlal Nehru, Vallabh Bhai Patel and Sitaramaiya. So the commission, it was a three member commission was formed, which again rejected the demand of linguistic. Then state reorganization commission was formed in 1956. So jab jaake jo hamare language ke base pe state form hue hain. So this was all about the regional movement in India. So now I'm moving to the last topic, which is a religious and communal movement. Religious and communal movement in India. In academic, in academic and political discourse, the term communal is used in a derogatory sense. In a derogatory sense, or representing narrow sectarian interest. So what is communalism? Let me define what is communalism. For communalism has a different meaning for different people, different organization, different institutions. So at the same time, it can be an ideology, it can be a belief, it can be a thinking, it can be a value, or it can be an instrument. So it can be used in a variety number of ways, in a variety of ways. So let me give this example. An individual have a multiple identities. So multiple identities based on the country, based on the gender, based on the sex, religion, place of birth. But a communal will always choose a communal identity, that is the religious identity, over all other identities. So we can say that superimposition of religious category over other categories, which becomes the starting point of communalism. So communalism in simple terms is a superimposition of religious category over all other categories. So the example of communalism in India are the anti-Sikh riots of 1984, the demolition of Babri Mosque Masjid in 1992, and the Godhra riots in 2002. So let me give a brief historical background of communal movement in India. The seeds of communalism are found in the British policy. The seeds of communalism in India is found in the British policy of divide and rule. Divide and rule, phoot dalo aur raj karo wali. So the policy of divide and rule was largely responsible for communal hatred among the different religious community in India. So along with Muslim communalism, Hindu communal sentiment were also intensified. This policy, which was centered around the issues of cow slaughter, conversion by Christian and Muslims. So reason for this communalism in India, we can highlight a few regions which was responsible for communalism in India. Number one was the Arya Samajists in the 19th century, they started Shuddhi movement. Shuddhi movement means movement for purification. They believe that जो इंडिया है इट इज फॉर हिंदूज और यहाँ पे सारे ही हिंदू रहे. क्या हुआ है, विद द कमिंग ऑफ मुगल्स स्टार्टेड कन्वर्टिंग हिंदू इनटू इस्लाम. सो दे स्टार्ट ए शुद्धि मूवमेंट कि हम उनको शुद्ध करेंगे और हिंदुज्म में वापस लाएंगे. सो दिस वॉज दी वन रीजन. एंड द सेकेंड रीजन वॉज दी सर सैयद अहमद खान वेन ही स्टार्टेड दी अलीगढ़ मूवमेंट एंड द फॉर्मेशन अलीगढ़ यूनिवर्सिटी ऑन द लाइन ऑफ रिलीजन. Then the role of communal organization. Communal organization means the formation of Muslim League in 1906, the formation of RSS and Vishu Hindu Parishad in 1915. Then we see the Swadeshi movement, the partition of Bengal in 1905. Then the separate electorate was given to the Muslims in 1909 by the Britishers. Lord Minto, who is regarded as a father of communal representation in India. Then the finally Bisharadan two nation theory, which is given by the Jinnah. So if you see all these region, if you count all these region, the basis of this region was the religion. So we can say these were the few region which was responsible for the rise of communalism in Indian politics. Let me give this religious demography of India. If you go by the census of 2011, we say that the Hindus are 80% and the Muslims are 14%. And the Christians are approximate 2% and Sikh are 2%. And the other minorities, other religious minorities like Buddhist, Parsi and Jain are approximate less than 2%. So this is the religious demography of India. So if Hindu communal and religious movement has its roots in the 19th century, the religious movement, jinko abhi highlight kiya hai. So issues related to communalism were based on the cow slaughter, issues of conversion, promotion of Hindi language, Hinduization of education, and the concept of Hindu Rast. Then we can also add the issues like uniform civil code and BJP wanted to remove this article 370, which has been removed now actually, and the demolition of Babri Masjid and the construction of Ram Temple. Uske liye bhi rasta clear ho gaya. So these are the other factors which also intensified the communal wave in India. So on the issues based on identities of religion, caste and ethnicity have also overshadowed the social and political process of India. Even Hindu Mahasabha and RSS, they also diminished the dream of Gandhi, which was based on Sarv Dharm Sambhav, equality of all religion. So let me give this, Antar, I will take 5 minutes more, and then I'll wrap up.
Yes, yes, no, sure, carry on.
We are running out of time, but I'll take 5 minutes, then I'll manage to finish.
So, yeah, no problem. Could I go ahead? Carry on, please. Yes, carry on.
Okay. Give me 5 minutes, Anna, because time is almost... Okay, so let me relate this with Babri Masjid and Ram Janam Bhumi. So if we see the resurgent spirit of Hindu communal association finally found its historic expression in the Ayodhya event. Ayodhya event means the demolition of Babri Masjid in 1992. So Ram Janam Bhumi has, see, it was not a new phenomena ki wo 92 mein hi aaya tha. It was a century old history. It has a century old history actually, Ram Janam Bhumi thing. In 1949, on 28 December 1949, all of a sudden, the idol of Ram Lala was installed in Ayodhya. So the huge riots broke out in the Ayodhya in 1949 as well. Then in 1992, after the 1992, 6 December 1992, the demolition Babri Drive. In 1985, mein kya hua tha? Rajiv Gandhi, he ordered the opening the gate of the controversial Babri Masjid for Hindus. Of Ram Lala for Hindus. So the gate of controversial Babri Masjid was opened in 1985. And the 1984, BJP was formed in 1984. Before 1984, it was a Jansangh. So if we see the election mandate of 1984, so BJP got only, if I'm not wrong, two seats and their voting percentage was 7.5. So after this using Ram Mandir issue, if you see the election mandate of 1989, BJP got 85 seats and their voting percentage was almost 12%. So BJP ko is cheez ka kafi fayda hua. Then BJP started using the Ayodhya thing for their electoral purpose. And then we saw the demolition of Babri Mosque in December 1992. Okay. Then in 2003, Vishwa Hindu Parishad announced that it would launch a nationwide campaign to reclaim 30,000 temples that had been converted into mosque. So it's not Muslim only that they are using this communal propaganda. Hindus are also actively using this communal propaganda to for their political purpose. So let me give you this, the Islamic religious communal movement. So Islam is one of the largest minority in India. Their population is approximate 40% as per the census of 2011. So along with Hindu religious social movement in the 19th century, the rising Muslim communal force was also quite visible in the first quarter of 20th century, or particularly with the formation of Muslim League in 1906. So they also started communalizing Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, particularly the Aligarh movement, the issues of Urdu language, demand of separate electorate for Muslims. They further communalized the Indian politics. So event like Khilafat movement in 1919 before the non-cooperation movement, then Mopila revolt or riots in Kerala, which was very famous, and the propaganda of two nation theory, which is given by the Jinnah, which this demand of two nation theory or demand for Pakistan, finally the partition of the country, but the outcome of this communal divide or communal politics. Even after the formation of secular India, the demand of maintaining exclusive identity remained constant of the Muslims. The formation of political party on religious line. There are many Muslim political parties. They always give this slogan that the Islam is in danger. So Islam, actually Hindu or Islam, is not in danger. Actually, these political parties are using this as a political tool. So along with the demand of for the separate electorate, the Urdu language has also acquired the religious color. So in India, approximately 60 million population of Muslims use, not Muslims, the people speak Urdu in India. 60 million population speak. So these Muslims, irrespective of their religion, their region, their tradition, they are demanding that the Urdu language should be included in the educational curriculum. So, but there are some Hindu fundamentalist groups, they do not want. It doesn't mean that if we include Urdu language in the education curriculum, to ye kafi survive karegi. Let's take example of Sanskrit. Sanskrit ko humne kar raha hai, lekin it could not survive. Log padhna bhi nahi chahte hain. So because these, whether it is a Sanskrit or Urdu, they are very rich language. Because of communal politics, they are losing its relevance. So then same with some people also relate Islam with the terrorist activities. Like in 2001, yes, the government banned the Student Islamic Movement of India. Which we call SIMI. The government found that it has the SIMI had a link with the Hizbul Mujahideen and the other terrorist groups. So it was banned in 2001 because it was involved in certain anti-state activities or terrorist activities. Even Hindu organization also blamed the Christian organization for conversion and all that. So here I would like to wrap up by saying that, today there's a need to revive Gandhian philosophy again. because Gandhi is very relevant. Indian philosophy was always based on the principle of Sarvdharma Sambhav, humanity. So irrespective of religion, there's a need. Even government of India, Modi also launched this Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat scheme to unite the India. So thank you very much for this lecture. Antar, over to you.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Santosh Mathur. It's again a clear picture, clear vision to the student to understand the ethnic movement, regional movement, and the other movement or communal movement in India. So you basically well structuredly deliver your lecture, start from the ethnic movement from Northeast, from Nagaland to from Meghalaya to from Tripura, and their political structure, how the ethnic movement playing an important role in the political system, in the state political systems, and the role of you come to the women movement, and then you come to the regional movement, and then you come to the communal movement. Communal movement, as everybody knows, how the Babri Masjid and how the different other communal movement provide a sense of awareness to the community of different religion to develop their communal movement in the political systems in India. So it's really well described, well structured, and well articulated of your lecture. So there are some questions, sir. Let me read one by one, and you can take you can answer the question. So the first question is the formation of new states, either by means of ethnic movement or regional movement, beneficial to the Indian economy? Basically, you want to ask if there is a new state, if the formation of a new state, for example, Chhattisgarh or Jharkhand or Uttarakhand, then the states are really contributing to the Indian economy or not?
So should I answer it?
Yes. Go by one by one.
Okay. So let me give this example of again the Uttarakhand, Jharkhand, and Chhattisgarh. So even this the State Reorganization Commission also emphasized on the rather than keeping the linguistic issue, the center should consider the administrative viability, administrative and economic viability for the creation of new state. So if we take a recent example of these three states, if you see the GDP of Chhattisgarh, even Uttarakhand and Jharkhand, they are doing quite good. So of course, by keeping the empirical example of these three states in mind, we can say that yes, in these three cases particularly, the creation of new state benefited the population of the Jharkhand and the tribal Jharkhand, Jharkhand and the people of Chhattisgarh and the Uttarakhand, in terms of economy, in terms of creation of jobs. So these three states are doing quite good. So in terms of economic viability, administrative viability, in every aspect. So I think these are the few criteria on which we can judge the success of a particular state.
Yes, absolutely. Let me put in this way. For example, if a state is newly formed, for example, Telangana, or for example, Chhattisgarh, or Jharkhand, or Uttarakhand.
Difficult to say because it is newly formed.
New state, right? Absolutely. In the initial time, when the state is formed, so the maximum contribution to the Indian economy or any economy is less, and substantially, gradually, once it grow day by day, like 1 year, 2 year, 5 year, 10 year, then their economic contribution is like much bigger than the other states. And as well as they are using the natural resources to provide a sense of job opportunity or the economic growth of that particular state. So yes, the formations of new states somehow provide a sense of job opportunity to their populations, as well as they contributing to the economic Indian economy aspect, or their economy as well. Okay, the next question is, do you think that religious movement have become an instrument for grappling political power?
Yes. You get that? Yes. Because as I said in the beginning, when I was defining the communalism, communalism is what? It is an ideology. It is an instrument. It is a tool. So it is a tool for what? It is an instrument for what? To fulfill their certain vested interest. Because BJP is saying that Hinduism is in danger. We have a 80% population of Hindus. Hindus are not in danger, but they are using this as a propaganda to fulfill their vested interest, vested political interest. You're getting my point, Antar?
Yes, yes.
So whether it is a Hindus, Muslim, and other religious community, they are by using the religion as a political tool is trying to fulfill their political, their vested political interest. Actually, it's true. Yes. I'm completely
agree. That's right. Absolutely. Yes, absolutely true. Like in India, we have a different religion and different religious group, and according to the religious group, we have a different political party as well. For example, the BJP, the Hindus, the radical Hindus support the BJPs, or the Dalits, AWSI in Hyderabad, their Muslims are supporting, or the Dalits, the Dalit in UP, they have a separate political party. So somehow, you can consider or you can take into consideration that the political party, those political parties belong a particular religion or community, they are trying to win the power through which they can develop their states into integrate or into inclusive of that particular community or particular group. Okay. So the next question is, comparison and difference between the ethnic movement of Punjab and Jammu Kashmir. Basically, it would be a class if you discuss it. So can you briefly divide or can you briefly distinguish this ethnic movement in Punjab and Jammu Kashmir?
Okay, ethnic movement, there were two ethnic movement in Punjab. One was 50s and 60s by the Punjabi Suba, that is the Akali Dal, which was based on Sikhism, right? So there's a fundamental difference, because the ethnic movement of Punjab was based on Sikhism, okay, Sikh religion. And see, first ethnic movement of Punjab was not demanding the separate state from Union of India. They were demanding autonomy from within the state. Okay, this was not true in Jammu Kashmir case. So even when in 1980s, there was another demand in Khalistan, they were also demanding the Khalistan separate state from the Union of India. So the first Punjabi Subhaman movement was completely different, but the Khalistan demand of Khalistan, we can to some extent can relate with the movement of Jammu and Kashmir. Because why we can relate? Because in both cases, they were demanding separate state or from the Union of India, in case of Khalistan and the Jammu and Kashmir. Second, on the basis of religion, because the movement of Jammu Kashmir is based on the Islam, Muslim identity, while this Khalistan is based on the Sikhism identity. So this is the fundamental difference between the ethnic movement of Punjab and the Jammu and Kashmir.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for your kind support and clear understanding on your different social movement, and also you have provided clear picture to the clear ideas to the students about the different social movement. So now, like, there is no more questions, and this is time to thank you. So on behalf of Odisha State Open University Sambalpur, I would like to thank you, Dr. Santosh Mathur, for your time, for your kind support, and for your kind lecture with well illustrated and well delivered lecture. We hope we will be in touch soon, and your lecture will be uploaded in our website. If you want, you can go through your lecture. Otherwise, I will send you the link, or I would request Amit Tripathi to please do send the link to our resource person, Dr. Santosh Mathur, by the evening, I hope. And I would like to thank you so much. I would also like to thank our technical person, Amit Tripathi, to for his technical support, for his coordinate with resource person to me and to students. And not for the least, I would like to thank our students. They have been so cooperative and they have been participating in every class, more or less, it is no matter what. But still they are active and still they are enthusiasm to learn or to understand new idea, new concept of different social movement and other different political concept. Thank you so much to all.
Thank you. Thank you, Antar, Amit, and all your lovely students. Take care.